beloved viewers, I greet you all in the name of Jesus. Today, in our Sunday, or what we call every Sunday bread, the bread of every Sunday, we have entitled that message in French, Pain Dominical. But in English, we can't translate it straight away. God has laid in my heart to share the word. And this word is entitled as a question, can a Christian be cursed? Can a Christian be cursed? There are a lot of debate in the world today. People are debating. Some are saying a Christian cannot be cursed. Some are saying that a Christian can be cursed. But the answer that I'm giving you today is yes and no. Yes, because the word Christian, we all know how it started. The word Christian is not an inspiration that came from God. No. It has a good meaning, but it did not come from God. When Jesus was on earth, he prepared his disciples, but there were also other religions that existed before. One of them, the greatest that time, Judaism, for the Jewish. It was one of the religion. Every people were identifying themselves through their religion. Now, when after Jesus ascended to the Father and the Holy Spirit descended upon the disciples, they began to preach. The world looked at them. They came with another message, a new message. To identify them, the world gave this word, give the name Christian to mean these are Christ followers, which is not bad. They are Christ followers. This is how they gave this name to identify them. Christian is not God inspiration. That's the reason why I'm saying yes, a Christian can be cursed. Then no, a Christian cannot be cursed. Why? When Jesus came on earth, he did not come to make us Christians. This is what the word of God says. Jesus said in the book of John, he said when the word came, he said to those who received him, he gave them power to become children of God. Jesus came to make as children of God. And for the first time on earth, a human being is going to call God the Father is through Jesus. This is one of the reasons the Pharisees, they did not like Jesus, because Jesus was calling God the Father. And even when Jesus taught how to pray, he said it. When you are praying, say, Our Father that is in heaven. He inaugurated another way, relationship. He brought us closer to God. He reconciled us to God. We are no longer subject, like in the Old Testament. God was the Lord and the man was a subject. But through Jesus Christ, we become children. Now we are children. Now, when you are born of the Word, when you are born of the Spirit, you are born again, child of God. You cannot be cursed. You cannot be cursed. But if you are there to Christian faith, maybe because your parents were Christian and you are born in a Christian family, then you become a Christian that way. Curse, generational curse. Yes, it's possible. It is possible. So I'm not against this name Christian, but I'm saying that it is not God's inspiration. Even Jesus, when he was talking to his disciples, he said, go and make of all nations my disciples. My disciples. Not Christians. My disciples. And Jesus never used this word at all. So the word was identifying a group of people who had another lifestyle. They had another message. They had another culture. Then they call them Christians. So, if you want to know if a Christian can be cursed, yes, he can be cursed if he's just a religious one. But when he's born again, a child of God, a born again child of God, because every child of God is Christian because he's a Christ follower. But every Christian may not be a child of God. He may not be a child of God. To be a child of God, you need to be born of God. You need to be born of the Word of God. You need to be born of the Spirit. That's when you are a child of. That's when you are a child of God. And when you are born again, you are a child of God, born again, you cannot be cursed. You cannot be cursed. I'm gonna read. The book of Galatians. Chapter 3, verse 29. The Bible says, and if ye be Christ's, then you are Abraham's seed and heirs according to the promise. You are the seed of Abraham if you are in Christ. That's what the Word of God is saying. You are the seed of Abraham. There was no curse in Abraham. But Abraham is the blessing. He was blessed. And when you become the seed of Abraham, simply because you are born again, you are in Christ. We share, now we are co-heir with Abraham. This is what the Word of God is saying. Another verse that I want us to see in the book of Romans chapter 4. Romans chapter 4. Reading verses 13 and 14. For the promise that he should be the heir of the world was not to Abraham or to his seed through the law, but through the righteousness of faith. For if they which are for the law be heirs, faith is made void, and the promise made for none effect. You understand here, they are saying simply that if you become the heir, of Abraham, according to the promise of God, that you are the heir of the world that they promised to Abraham, it is not according to the law. It is not, because you are Jewish or because you were born in Israel. No. If it is like that, faith is void. That's what the Word of God says. It is given to you. That promise was given to you. You are blessed. And Abraham is blessed. And he was the blessing. Through faith, you become a blessing. There is no way a blessing can be cursed. This is the truth that we need to know. Though some people today, they still believe that, this sickness I have, my father had the same, or my mom had the same, or it is a hereditary or something which is in the gene. Yes, you can explain, scientifically speaking, you can explain. But through the Word of God, through faith, you can be the first one not to suffer that sickness. This is the truth of the Word of God. This is the truth of the Word of God. When Jesus healed this lady on the Sabbath day, remember Luke 13, on verse 16. Jesus said something again. I'm reaching the end of my message. Can I just say Luke 13, verse 16. The Bible says, "And ought not this woman, being a daughter of Abraham, whom Satan had bound, lo, these 18 years be loosed from this bond on the Sabbath day?" Jesus was asking them a question, because when this woman was healed, these people, they are saying that by this healing on the Sabbath day, it is unlawful to heal on the Sabbath day. And Jesus said, "Is she not a daughter of Abraham? Is she not the seed of Abraham to be healed on the Sabbath day? She has the right. There is no law that can hold you down in your sickness, in your curse, in your generational curse. When you believe this way, every time remember, when you see something that's similar in the family, it killed the uncle, it killed the father, it killed the mom, it killed the auntie, then you are seeing the same symptoms, just say, you are the seed of Abraham. You are in Christ. And if you are in Christ, you are a new creature. And behold, everything is new." This is what the Word of God says. You need just to be aware of this. And you need to trust the Word. You are watching me now. After hearing this Word, what is your decision? Are you still holding that sickness in you? Are you still holding that curse upon your life? No. This is an opportunity that God has given you. I'm going to pray for you. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for the Word. We thank you for this knowledge of the Word. Father, every person that has listened to this Word, be blessed and be aware that they are the seed of Abraham when they're in Christ. There is no generational curse. They cannot be cursed in the name of Jesus Christ. We are not religious people. We are children of God. We are not only Christian, but we are children of God. We are born again Christian. May God richly bless you. Amen.